How did you learn? A lot of drummers get lessons. A lot of drummers teach themselves. How did you kind of go about it? When did you start?
So I self-taught.
Yep.
According to my parents, I was banging away on the wooden spoons when they were watching Live Aid.
Yep.
Phil Collins, they reckon, is they're going to credit him with me starting, which isn't a bad thing, I suppose.
Yeah.
But outside of that, man, I used to just whatever I could get my hands on to hit at home, like wooden spoons, pots and pans. I think by the time I had broken enough of my mum's kitchen stuff, they were kind of like, you get them a kit now. So I got my first kit when I was about 14.
Yeah.
But my parents were super supportive. Like, I used to come home, like I would race home from school, knowing that my dad was like, look, you can have an hour to play every day. It's awesome, I get an hour to practice drums every day. So I'd come home, race home from school, play for an hour, and then my dad would come in and be like, you can have another hour. I'm like, oh yes, I'd be thrashing away, and you know, you don't think of it at the time, but now I look back, I'm like, holy shit, I was playing drums in a, you know, not the largest house, no soundproofing for 2-3 hours a day. And my dad was like, yeah, you go for it. Holy shit, they're good. Super supportive.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
So I guess you started off just using your ears, and then later down the track, you kind of taught yourself how to read.
So I ended up just getting a lot of books and some videos, and trying to teach myself how to read, more out of frustration of not being able to do it, and the fact that there was so much information available and so much content out there that I couldn't use because I didn't know how to read. I was like, right, I need to learn how to read that. The first book I actually, once I was pretty comfortable reading like basic notation, the first book I really got into was Future Sound, David Garibaldi book.
It's
all like linear grooves and stuff.
Nice.
Which was awesome for me. It was a whole new world.
Yeah.
Like, linear playing was such a foreign concept to me at the time because I was like straight rock grooves and like big 16th fills and stuff. When I started taking that on, I was like, oh man, whole new world.
Yeah.
There's so much more stuff. It's cool.
So obviously, with going to the gym and being, you're not drinking and smoking, it'd be a lot easier in a way.
Yeah, I'm very well rested.
You handle a little bit better.
Definitely.
Yeah, no, it's good.
But I, because I'm diabetic as well, so it's better. If I'm not maintaining that, it makes life a whole lot harder, especially touring. Like, it's not the friendliest of schedules at the best of times, so definitely got to maintain that.
And with the yoga stuff, is that, so you obviously get physical and kind of mental benefits out of that type of thing.
Yeah.
Do you find that kind of helps you keep going into a gig, like it helps your mind space a little bit?
Yeah, I used to find like it's hard to get that into that right mindset sometimes before a gig. So you kind of got all that energy, the nervous energy flowing.
Yeah.
You know, it can lead to a bit of anxiety. You want to play the best you can. You kind of start thinking, what if this goes wrong?
Yeah, right.
There's so much that can go into the prep for a gig.
Yep.
These days, like, I find it so easier, so much easier to kind of get into that, like, mindset.
Yeah.
Just a lot more relaxed before I play. Like, I'll warm up for about 20 minutes.
Wow,
and
nice.
And kind of just chill.
Cool.
And then by the time I get to stage, like, I'm not thinking about this could happen. It's like you're there in the moment for that song. And the next song, it's like, I used to get, you know, you make a mistake and you start thinking about that mistake for the rest of the room. The next song, whereas now I find if I made a mistake, I leave that there, move on. The rest of the set could be amazing. Also, try not to get too caught up in that, which is cool.
Just do we get the feel like when you first start playing shows, you kind of have that. Well, I used to have the feeling that I must have a feeling before you play, I'm a bit anxious, as you were saying, excited, you get out there and still, you know, it's a special moment when you're on stage, when you have a good gig. You still get that?
Yeah, man, every time. Like, even playing like covers to nobody, like, I still get that. When you feel like you've played as well as you could have.
Yeah.
Like you're on stage playing to someone. I don't think there's ever a greater moment of clarity when I'm on stage, or like there's that kind of, like everything else stops, you just locked into that moment. I think there's nothing else that can be that moment truer than being on stage. Usually when I'm on, once the gig's on, that's all I'm playing the songs. But I'm not thinking about, oh, this part's coming up or anything. It's like, as long as you're rehearsed enough and comfortable with the material, it is like second nature. So you shouldn't. I find if I'm thinking about something, I'm not in the right headspace.
Yeah,
because you're kind of, again, you're like, oh, worried about, oh, this bit's coming up. Well, how do I play this bit again? And it kind of takes away from being in that present moment and just enjoying playing on stage. But we run everything to click, a lot of samples, so I guess if I fall out of time for some reason, it's the safety net where at least I know where I am in the song.
Are you controlling the samples? Is it
it's all just run up able to spacebar, track starts.
Is it you, spacebar?
Yeah. I'm good at the spacebar.
Yeah, nice one. Thanks for chatting with me, brother.
Pleasure.
You're the man. I'm looking forward to the show.
Thanks, Chris.
Looking forward to learning a thing or two. Probably get in the practice room tomorrow and go bananas.
Yeah.